This Supro starting salary is 5000 and every year it gets an increment of ₹200. So in which year it gets a salary of ₹7000? That is the question mark here. So starting he gets 5000, every year he is getting ₹200 increment. So his salary will be like this. His salary in consecutive years. Rupees 5000 in the first year, then 5200 in the second year, so 5400 it goes, and at the end he gets 7000. So now in which year he gets rupees 7000, that is the question mark. So as these numbers are in AP, so you can write it is in AP, it is in arithmetic progression. So with the starting A, first number is rupees 5000. And common difference 3, you know it is 200. Every year it increases by ₹200, therefore common difference is 200. Then n term an is equal to, it is 7000. So last term is 7000. So let us write here an 7000. We need to calculate n. In which year it gets rupees 7000? That means n we need to find out. So let us use the formula. An is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. This is the formula. So substitute here, an is 7000, a value, first term is 5000. So then n minus 1 into d value, it is 200. So transfer this 7000 to the left side. 7000 minus 5000 is equal to 200 multiplied. 200 n minus 200. So this is 2000. So is equal to 200 n minus 200. So 200 n will be equal to, so 2000 plus transfer. So 200 minus becomes plus. So 200 n is equal to 2200. So n is equal to 2200 divided by 200. So 2020 cancels, 21s are 211s are. So he gets 7000 rupees salary in the 11th year. So his salary in the 11th year is rupees 7000. So this is the solution. In which year he gets 7000, that is the question mark. So in the 11th year he gets rupees 7000. Let us see now the formula to find out the sum of first n terms of an AP. So what is the sum of first n terms of an AP? Suppose I take one AP, look at this, 2, 4, 6, 8, this is an AP, arithmetic progression. If I want sum of first two terms, means sum of first two terms, S2, I will write S2, sum of first two terms means S2, that is nothing but 2 plus 4, it is 6. If you add only two numbers, it gives you sum of first two numbers. If I add three numbers, then I will write S3, sum of first three terms, that is 2 plus 4 plus 6. So it becomes 12, sum of the first three terms. If I ask sum of first four terms, it is 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8, then it becomes 20. So that is the meaning of sum of first n terms. If I say in place of n, if I write 2, sum of first 2 terms. In place of n, if I write 3, sum of first 3 terms. So there is a formula to find out. There is no need to add. Suppose if I ask the sum of 100 terms, there is no need to add individually all the 100 terms, write term, place and add. So that is not required here. So you can find out this sum using one formula. So we will derive that formula. Before we go to that formula, there is an interesting story related to this sum of n terms. So you might have heard the famous mathematician Gauss. So he was very intelligent in the school. When he was at the age of 10 years, so he was very mischievous in the class. Whatever the question teacher asked, immediately he used to give the response, and he will be busy in disturbing the class. So the teacher wanted him to engage, so that he will not disturb the class. What he did, he gave a work. When he was teaching, he told, okay, come on, you add the numbers from 1 to 100. Teacher told to Gauss, add the numbers from 1 to 100. What is his work? add 1 plus 2 plus 3. So up to 100 you add. This was the work given to Gus. So when the teacher gave this work, immediately within no time he responded and gave the answer as 5050. So then teacher surprised and asked him how you got within a short span of time. So then he replied like this. His method was like this. This is the sum of first 100 terms, natural numbers. What he did is the same thing what he did, he reversed this one. So 100, then the previous number is 99, then 98, like this it goes, and the first term will be at the last. So 1 to 100 we wanted to add, he reversed these numbers, then he added these numbers. What happens here? Sum of 100 two times will come. Sum of first 100 terms two times will be there. So that is equal to 101, 99 plus 2 again 101, 98 plus 3 again 101. So look at this. So when you add like this, you will get all 101s. Now you tell me how many 101s will be here total. How many 101s will be here? He is adding like this. There will be 100 101s. You know that a simple way of, okay, 101 plus 101 plus 101, this there will be 100 times. So 100 times you have to add. So this 101 there will be 100 times. You know the simplest way of addition is multiplication. If there are 201s, what you will do? 101 into 2. If there are 301s, 101 into 3. If there are 10 101s, 101 into 3. Here how many 101s are there? We have 100s. 100 101s. So therefore 2 times this 100 is 101 into 100. Just you multiply 100 to this 101, you will get the sum of this number. Because he knows that easiest way of addition is multiplication. So here we have 2 times the sum. 100s, 1 to 100, we are added here. Again, in the reverse way also we added. 2 times we added here. So therefore, this value will be 2 times the addition of 1 to 100. So now, I want only S 100 means. So 101 into 100 divided by 2. Divided by 2. So divide this one, 2 ones are 250. 50 into 101 you multiply, you will get 5050. This is the answer he gave to the teacher. So what he did, in a mind itself he calculated 1 to 100 he wrote, and the reverse of this one, 199, and he saw that the sum is always getting 101 only. So then 101s, how many will be there? He guessed that there will be 100 101s. So 100 101s means the sum will be 100 into 101. Since he added 2 times, so they divided by 2, so 50 into 101. So that is the sum. 50 into 101 means 5050. That is the sum of numbers from 1 to 100. This basic concept led to the discovery of a formula, the sum of first 10 terms of an arithmetic function. This is the basic or core concept behind this discovery of this sum of n terms of an arithmetic progression. Using this method itself, we are going to find out the sum of first n terms of this arithmetic progression. So let us use the same concept here and find out the formula here. How to find the formula of sum of first n terms. So now, before we go to that, let us take, this is an AP only. Let us take one AP here. So let the AP be. So let us write. Let the AP be like this. First term, let us take A. The second general form only we are taking A plus D. And third term will be A plus 2D. Like that it goes. So we want last term. Nth term, you know, AN will be there. AN. Okay, AN is the nth term. So now, we want to find out the sum of these N terms. So what is the sum of N terms? I want to find out the formula of sum of N terms. Sum of n terms. So I can write that as sum of n terms as Sn. Sn is equal to, I want to add a plus b second term, then third term is a plus 2d. Like this, I want to add all the terms, the last term is an. So I am writing an itself. See the first term here a, second term, third term, and the last term. We want the sum of these numbers. Sum of all these terms. So for that I can write plus everywhere. So we want to add all these terms up to n terms. Now what he did, what the Gauss did, he reversed this AP. So this, let us find out once again, we write here. So here, an, you know that I instead of, okay, let us write an here itself. So your first term, an will be the first term. So once you are going back, you have to subtract the common difference. See, once first term is there, you want second term, means add the common difference. First term you have A, second term will be plus B. Okay, second term A plus D comes. Then you want third term, means another D you add. So in the same way, you come back from the last, AN is there, its previous term, you have to minus D. One D should be subtracted from this one. So what will be this second term, can you tell me, previous term of AN? Is it possible to tell? When you are going forward, you should add. When you are coming backward, you should subtract. Tell me, what is that?
An
minus D. Right. So here, let me write that as An minus D. First term, the last term we have written first, and the previous term here in the second place. And can you tell me what would be next to its previous term, An minus D? It must be? An minus 2D. Right. So when you are coming backward, you should subtract D every time. When you are going forward like this, you should add the common difference. First term A, second term will be A plus D, third term will be A plus D, A plus 2D. Every time you are adding a common difference. In the same way, when you are coming backward, every time you should subtract the common difference. So last term is AN, then its previous term must be AN minus D, then its previous term must be AN minus 2D. Like this, what will be the first term? First term is this one. I will write here at the end, A. So just like 1, 2, 3 up to 100, then we reverse the term. 100, 99, 98, the last one will be 1. Same thing we have done here. So then let us add these two arithmetic progressions. So Sn and Sn, 2 times you are adding. So let us write 2 times Sn. We are adding 2 times. So here, 1 plus 100 was there now. What you got? 1 plus 100, you got 101. In the same way, here A and A plus An, both are unlike, you cannot add like 100, 101, 101, you cannot write that. So you can write here, An plus A. An plus A. This is the sum of these two terms. Come to the second one. Here when you add A plus B plus An minus B, what is the sum? A plus B, An minus B. When you add these two, what is the sum?
An plus A
itself, B and D, see, plus B and minus B cancels. You will be left with only An plus A itself. So again, An plus A. Every time you are getting 101, remember, in the same way, here also you should get the same number. An plus A, here also An plus A. Again, here minus 2D and plus 2D cancels, you will get only An plus A. So third one also. Like this, it continues. Again, you are getting An plus A. So now you tell me, how many times this An plus A will be there? How many times? N times. You are right, N times. So in that numbers, natural numbers from 1 to 100 means 100 numbers, 101, 100 numbers were there. Here, we want to find out the sum of N terms. You will be having N terms here. An plus A will be N times. So therefore, 2 times Sn will be equal to, what is the sum of this one means? So you have to, this will be n times we will be adding. Okay, so now we want to find out the sum of this one means. So what is the sum of this an plus a? Easiest way of, n into an plus a. N into an plus a is the sum. Okay, now we have here, I told this is 2 times, we have added 2 times, but I want only 1 time. So then what happens, Sn is equal to, you transfer this 2 to the denominator, it becomes n by 2 into a plus an, I write a plus an. Sometimes what we, this is one formula to find out the sum of n terms, instead of an, sometimes we write l, last term. Sn is equal to n by 2 into a plus n. So instead of a n, sometimes we use a n as l, last terms. In some formula we use l to show the last term. This is one way. So what we got, Sn is equal to n by 2 into a plus a n. This is the formula we got. So you remember this one. Once you know the first term and the last term, you can use this formula. Suppose if I change this a n, let me write this a as it is. A n I am going to change. What is the nth term of an AP formula? You know that. A n is equal to what?
A plus n minus 1 into d.
This is the formula. You substitute that. This is the nth term formula. So in place of a n, you can write this one. So simplify this one. S n is equal to n by 2 into a plus a 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So this is the formula to find out the sum of first n terms of an AP. Formula to find out the first n terms of an AP. So what is the difference between this one? This is also one formula. This is another formula. What is the difference when we use this form? We use this formula and when we use this one?
Sir, when the last term is given, we can use first.
When the last term and the first term is given, you can use this one. Here common difference is not required here. Number of terms, if you know the number of terms, first term and last term, you can use directly this one. Here, when the last term is not given, only the number of terms, first term and the common difference is given, you have to use this formula. So both you can use wherever it is required, you can use these two formula accordingly. So this is a formula to find out the sum of first n terms of an arithmetic progression. Is it clear? What is the question? Find the sum of first 22 terms. That means n is equal to 22 here. And the arithmetic progression given is this one. 8, 3, minus 2. So we have to find out sum of first 22 terms. Yes, 22. So we need to find out the sum of first 22 terms. And the arithmetic progression from this, you can find out a is equal to 8 and d is equal to 3 minus 8. It is minus 5. We don't have the last term. So therefore, which formula we have to use here? Sn is equal to n by 2 2a plus n minus 1 into d. N minus 1 into d. Okay. Now S22. We want to find out the sum of first 22 terms. Substitute the value. N value, in place of n you write 22. 22 by 2. 2 into. A value, first term, it is 8. First term here 8 plus n minus 1. 22 minus 1. And the common difference it is given, that is minus 5. So you can write that common difference as minus 5. So this becomes minus 5. So simplify this one. 22 by 2 gives you 11. So 11, 2 8s are 16. Then 22 minus 1 means 21 into minus 5. So again, let us simplify inside bracket first. 16 minus, it becomes 21 into minus, plus into minus, minus 21 into 5. 5 1s are 5, 5 2s are 10. 105. Now 11 into 16, you need to subtract from 105. So 15 minus 5, it is 9. So here 9 minus 1, 8. Isn't it? So 89. 89 is the difference now. Minus 89. Okay. Minus 89. So then, if you multiply this one, it should be a negative number. 11 9s are 99. So 9, 11 8s are 88 plus 9. 97. So this is the sum of first 22 terms. Why we are getting a negative number here? Because this is decreasing, AP is decreasing. Afterwards, after minus 2, you all get negative numbers only. So 22 terms are there. Out of that, only 2 numbers are positive. Remaining all are negative only. Therefore, you should get the sum only, a negative number only. So this is the sum of first 22 terms of this given AP. Is it clear to all of you? The given question is like this. Find the sum of the first 14 terms. We need to find out the sum of the first 14 terms. So that means S14 is to be calculated here. S14. So this we need to calculate here. Sorry, it is given. Sum of first 14 terms is given, that is 1050. Sum is given. Sum of the first 14 terms is given, that is 1050. And its first term is also given. So first term means A is 10. So we need to find out the 20th term. A20 we need to calculate. 20th term means A20 we need to calculate. So now we have S14 and A only. Using this you need to find out the value of this 20th term. And another thing you can notice here, first 14 terms. So here n is equal to 14. So n is equal to 14 only. There are 14 terms. So n you can take it as 14 here. So use this formula and find out the value of d here. You can find out the value of d here. We need a and d to calculate the any term of this arithmetic progression. So which formula you can use? Nth term formula. So let us use, sorry, sum of first n terms. Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So Sn is given, it is 1050, sum of first 14 terms. N value is 14 by 2. 2a, first term is given, it is 10. You can substitute here, first term is 10. 2a, 2 into 10 plus n minus 1, 14 minus 1 into d, it is not given, we have to calculate. So now you can transfer 2 to the left hand side. 0, 2, 5 are 10, 1, 2 are 2100. Is equal to 14 into 2 tens are 20 plus 13d. Okay, so you are getting 2100 is equal to 14 into 13d. So now 14 into, now you simplify the remaining things now. What you will get, let us see now. 14 you can transfer. 2100 divided by 14 is equal to, because it's a multiplication, you will get 20 plus 13d. So this is the equation you are getting. You can divide this one from 2. 2 7s are 2 1s are 0, 2 5s are then 0. Okay. Then again you divide by 7. 7 1s are 7, 7 1s are 3 remains 35, 7 5s are 35, 150. So you have 150 is equal to 20 plus 13d. Or 13d is equal to 150 minus 20. So 13d is equal to 130. Now you simplify this one now. So what you will get? 13d is equal to, so we have 13d is equal to 130, d is equal to 130 divided by 30, so common difference is equal to 10. So you got the common difference 10, and a is also 10 only. A is 10, d is 10, you can find out any term. Now which term you have to find out here? 20th term. So an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. You have to use nth term formula here to find out the 20th term. So a20 is equal to a. First term is also 10, n minus 1, 20 minus 1, d is also 10 only. Simplify this one, 10, this is 19 into 10. So 10 plus 19 into 10, 190. So 190 plus 10, it is 200. So 20th term of this arithmetic progression is 200. This is the solution.